Hello, everyone. I'm Steve Busalocki, Super Bolt Global Product Manager.
Hi, I'm Bob McCurdy, Super Bolt Product Manager for North America. Today, Steve and I are going to introduce the Super Bolt tool and show you the proper use, how to install and remove multi-jack bolt tensioners. Let's head over to our training lab and have a closer look at this innovative, award-winning Super Bolt tool. Let's start off with the basics of the Super Bolt tool. First off, you have the drive unit. This is offered in three different sizes to cover the multiple ranges of Super Bolt tensioners. We have a drive shaft. We also have the power cassette. The power cassette matches to each individual multi-jack bolt tensioner. You can see the amount of sockets on here to match up with your jack bolts. You also need a click wrench. This will be used for preparation and final torque of the jack bolts.
The Super Bolt tool brings great benefit, particularly when you have a large number of Super Bolts of the same size. For this video, we're just going to focus on one Super Bolt tensioner just to show you the basic steps and operation of the Super Bolt tool.
Regardless of which version you use, if you do it tightening by hand or using a Super Bolt tool, you always need to prepare the Super Bolt tensioner properly. You want to look for your stud, should be even with the top of the nut, or maybe a couple of threads sticking out. We do not want to have a stud sticking out too high to interfere with the jack bolt rotation. At this time, what we're going to do, we're going to use our click wrench. We're going to put a minimal load on each jack bolt. We're going to make one full circle. All you're doing now is you're preparing your joint for the Super Bolt tool to be able to be used. So we'll start here on the top.
So we have a prescribed low setting and we just need to do one round.
Just one round is all we need.
Just to get things set.
That's correct. Okay, now we're ready to install the Super Bolt tool. We're going to start with the power cassette. The power cassette has unique auto-align sockets. Makes it easy to go on to the multi-jack bolt tensioner. After this is set down, now we'll actually use our drive unit with the drive shaft. You can see each unit has a numbering system. On the one side it has a 1, on the back side has a number 2. Number 1 is used for installation. Number 2, we'll show later, is used for removal. You take your drive gear into side 1. This now connects up to your power cassette. One thing you want to watch for, there's actually a small arrow on the drive unit. There's actually dimples around the power cassette. This arrow should line up with those dimples. That makes sure all the gearing is actually meshed together. In this case, you can see I'm not completely lined up. By simply turning the input drive here, I can adjust the unit. Drops right in.
I see they also have shear pins here, which helps
Good point, for
safety, so you know that everything is engaged. You know, with those dimples and everything getting lined up, everything is safe and secured. We're ready to do the full tightening. So over here, we have different options for input tools. As Bob explained, we have our main drive unit, and we can adapt it to various input tools based on the application or customer preference. And just a couple of examples here, we have a battery tool here that can be very useful depending on application. Here's another style battery driver. And other situations, we can use an air motor, you know, which is very heavy duty. So again, it's based on the application, adapting with working with the customer as to what suits best for the application. So a lot of versatility there. Okay, we're ready for tightening now with the power cassette and drive unit. We will do the full tightening of the Super Bolt. Here's our input tool, just a nice battery tool here. And we adapt it to the drive unit with this adapter, which is splined. So it mates nicely in here. We have square drive with a square input there, but these splines enable secure connection and also anti-rotation for safety.
Okay, as Steve mentioned with the splines, we're gonna match this up to our drive unit. You can see it did not go all the way in. Again, that's that square. We have to make sure that it fits all the way down into the hole. By pulsing, the tool drops right in. Once it's in, we again double check, everything's secure, down nice and tight. The drive unit is actually ready to go. Squeeze the trigger, see the jack bolts turning
simultaneously.
Now you can see, if I go to try and remove this, the unit is actually stuck a little bit. That's normal. The jack bolts or the sockets, as they're turning on the jack bolt, put a little pressure on each socket. So what we'll do, hit it in reverse. All I'm going to do is just pulse this unit to release the sockets. There, you can see once it's released, you can take that, Steve. The whole unit slides right off.
So we just did the majority of the tensioning with the SuperBolt tool, where we took out all the effort from the normal hand wrench, but we need to ensure that we fine-tune the jack bolts to get them to the prescribed setting. So generally this requires 1 to 2 passes, depending on the length of the stud. Longer studs may require 2, but generally 1 or 2 passes just to fine-tune the jack bolts to bring them to equilibrium. And we follow just like our normal procedure. If that wrench is moving less than 20 degrees, okay, we can stop. So Bob, why don't you go ahead and do that final pass. Okay, so I think this will be pretty good for one pass. Yep.
Now we're back to the first jack bolt.
Okay, so we did one pass. The wrench was moving less than 20 degrees, so we've reached the precise setting for the jack bolts. We are complete. So we'll get started here, get our power cassette, and put that back over the SuperBolt tensioner.
Now, as mentioned, we need to take our drive shaft from side one. Since we're doing removal, we now need to go to side two. Install the drive shaft. Same thing applies. We need to make sure our arrow lines up with one of our dimples. If it does not line up, again, just by simply turning the input drive here, I can move it, and you see it drop right in.
Line up. Let me get you.
Everything's
tool.
Lined up.
There you go, Bob.
So we're in. Now we'll actually begin the removal process. We focus on the jack bolt. Now at this point, the jack bolts are all loose. You can see everything turned out. Some cases, you could actually continue with this until the jack bolts come completely out if you wanted for extra cleaning.
That's it?
That's it. That's all it is. Take your unit back off. Got it. And you can see the nut spins freely.
Fantastic.
So there you have it, installation and removal using the SuperBolt tool. You can see how effective this product is when you're using the right applications, particularly when you have multiple tensioners of the same size.
Well, thanks for watching this video, and please reach out to us at the Nordlock Group for more information on the SuperBolt tool or for help with any other bolting challenges you may have.